Greetings, salutations. Hey girl, hey, what's going on guys? A little bit chiller of a greetings for you all. I wanted to do like a casual vlog setting where I could appease some of my vlog viewers who are missing my second channel, as well as do something a little bit more lax, enjoyable, makeupless, most likely the whole vlog. You're catching me on one of my rare days where my hair is straight. That's always the day after wash night. So I washed it last night and I blow dry it, you know, with a round brush, and this is what it looks like the next day. Sometimes the day after that, I'll just tie it back, and then I'm usually like waved or curled the rest of the time. But you know, I try not to heat style it every single day, so this is just gonna be one of those, it's gonna do what it wants type of days. So I just know that this side's always gonna flip out on me, so. Anywho, you may see a bunch of clothes all over the place right now, and that's because I wanted to show you guys some of the things I picked up. Not sponsored or anything, this is just some things that I have recently purchased. I haven't been purchasing clothes for a while, as most of you know. 2019, I really didn't buy much at all. I think I bought like a birthday outfit for like 90 bucks and that was it. For the most part, 2020, I didn't really need anything because we're not going anywhere. It's like a pandemic, it's a quarantine, it's still happening. I don't go anywhere, I haven't eaten out at all. I'm still like a takeout, cook at home, that's my life. So loungewear, big priority, as well as workout gear, because I've been working out a lot more. So I wanted to get some new items because the other pairs I have were either getting a little tight or getting a little uncomfortable, or also I just didn't have enough of my favorites. You know when you find a new one that you really love and you want every single color of them? That's kind of the mode I was in. So the first thing I want to show you guys are some of these leggings. This is my favorite situation I got going on right now. Do you see these three? Do you see the aesthetic? The first pair are by Aries. I feel like everyone's sleeping on Aries workout leggings because they are the bombest leggings ever. I didn't purchase any, like I said, last year. My sister actually gifted me a pair she bought for herself that didn't fit. So she had a black pair. She was like, they're really nice, but they just don't fit me, so you can have them. And I started wearing them and they were my favorite. You know, when you dig through your drawers to find that one pair, they're my pair. They are probably the smoothest, softest leggings I've ever worn. I've worn a few pair of Lululemon Connoisseur, but I would say if there's anything that I would bet my money on is comparable as far as softness goes, these are amazing. These are high-waisted and I think they're the 7/8. So they come in different styles. These are the softest when they're not meshed. They have thicker styles, which I do have. Oh, wait, there's more, 1 second. All right, so I still had a pair in the bag. So I didn't actually put it with my group shots, but come on aesthetic. Okay, she's a vibe, right? So I'm getting into these like light brownish, purplish, mauve-y situations. So I bought two from Aerie and two from Gymshark. So those are my current favorite purchases, but there are more that I thought I'd try on with you guys. So the Aerie situation, yes, the 7/8 leggings, softest things in the world. I bought a pair of thicker leggings and these are called Chill Play Move, I guess, and they say info for it right here. So I bought this in a small, this is also a high rise, it has pockets. So my girls who like pockets in their leggings, there's one on each leg. This is just a thicker pair where I'm like, okay, it's getting cold, I'll need these. Because my favorite ones, the 7/8s, that have no mesh or no design or anything, they're just high waisted and super silky, they are thin, you know, they're thinner things. They're great for all year round to me, but if you're gonna wear these alone in winter, you are a little chilly, you know? So I could literally live in these all day. It's a second skin, they're so amazing, and I feel like everyone's sleeping on them. They're super good, and they're 30% off right now, so hopefully the sale's still going by the time you guys see it. And then I also ordered two pairs of Gymshark leggings. These are closer to about 50 bucks a piece, while these were around the 30s after being on sale. And these were two pairs that I really wanted to show you guys. So I'll show you guys them on as well. So the first one is the Dreamy leggings, the lighter color. This one also has pockets inside. They're higher than the other pair, but honestly, amazing leggings, like super soft, but they are very, very long. So I'm about 5'6", and most leggings are fine to me. If anything, like a little short, they give me that ankle gap. I don't need an ankle gap. My ankles be cold all the time. But these are a little bit bunched at the bottom, and I can tell they're a little longer, so keep that in mind. I purchased these in a medium, and I'm happy I did. They're not super tight, but I think the small would have been too tight. And just like every brand, all the sizing isn't always consistent. So for the Aerie brand, I tried on a pair of the mesh leggings. In a small, they were too tight, so I would have needed a medium in that. But everything else, I needed a small. Same thing for Gymshark. Like, everything I usually get a small, but I needed a medium in Dreamy because I felt like they would run tiny. So this pair, I don't actually remember the name, but I will give you the info for it. This has, like, the designs and the ripples on it. This one, I believe, is a small, and she's thick too, so she's way thicker than the Dreamy leggings. The Dreamy leggings have like a really soft velvet feel almost to them, like almost like a soft, I don't know, a soft lining, we'll go with that. And then these are just like your standard, like thick, really hugging, tummy flattering, no camel toeing type of leggings, all really pretty. And they're all similar colors, but they're all like a little different. Like this one's more purple and this one's more brown. So yeah, now that I look like a all-around psychopath, I'm also wearing one of their bralettes. You can see the padding, which is a little annoying to me. Like, that's not my nipple, that's actually like the crease of the padding. But I like how like seamless and like comfy it is. Really amazing. I also bought a strappier black pair. I got this one in a large, this one in a medium, and she fits well. I tried them on at the store. It's the first time I went back to a store in a while. Actually, yeah, first time I went to the store this whole freaking year. I usually just send Chris to do any in-store pickups. And it wasn't a great experience, even though I was the only one in the store. It wasn't great. And the other clothes you may see on my floor right now are all actually from Yes Style. So Yes Style is nice enough to let me just try some of their stuff every month. So once a month I get like a Yes Style order, and I just pick out some things. So I picked out a bunch of clothes, some loungewear. I wanted to see if these leggings, they weren't that expensive. And I got them in three different colors. A little mauve, a little gray, and a little black. Haven't tried these on yet, so I don't know how they compare. They don't feel as soft as my favorite leggings of all time, but they don't feel bad. There's a few tie-dye stuff, a random pair of black loungewear pants. I got a pink athletic set. She's a little too bubblegummy actually for me now that she's arrived, but I'll give her a go anyway. I don't know how well she's gonna fit. I got a black and white version of the same shirt where it kind of cinches in the middle just for like recording. I know it's not gonna be great for the weather that's about to, you know, start up on us, but seemed like a cute shirt. I don't have the proper undergarments for that yet because the nippy skins, the covers I usually use, I needed a new pair. That time, and they're not here yet, so I don't know if I can try this on for you right now. I got two pairs of sweatpants, a tan and a white. I'm hoping they're really comfortable. They're soft to the touch, like on the inside, which I like. All my sweatpants have gotten like not soft on the inside, like started really soft, but 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, I feel like I need new sweatpants. And for some reason, my favorite pair of sweatpants from Cotton On are missing, and I have a feeling they got damaged a long time ago and I threw them out and I totally forgot because we had like a Tide Pod situation in the dryer, or not dryer, in the washer once upon a time. I have a black and a gray loungewear set. We'll see if I can try this on. I might try to take the padding from this and just use that instead. And then I got this random like knockoff Brandy Melville situation where it's like an open sweatshirt. And I say knockoff Brandy Melville because it says like Brody Melvin instead of Brandy Melville. I don't think that's exactly the words, but you know what I'm saying. So there's a little situation there. And then a random pair of velvet red terracotta pants. You can see them from here. They just looked really soft. They don't come in any neutral colors. Let it be what it is. If they're comfy, they're comfy, and they're perfect for neighbor nightly hangout times. So I gave you guys some try-on clips for the leggings already, but let me quickly do some try-ons for the other things before I start lunch for the kids, because they literally have lunch in like 10 minutes and I need to do the dishes. So that's on the agenda. Let's get started. So these are the Yes Style leggings in the gray. I'm not sure if these would ideally be something I'd wear again. Let me check the size real quick. These are mediums, so there is probably a higher size, but these fit like your traditional smalls. I did feel a little bit of tension and a few stitches popping when I pulled them up. Would I be able to work out in these? probably. It's not the worst thing, but I can feel a lot of tension pulling down. So weigh that how you want to with the cost. I'll give you guys some quick shots of the purple and the black. They're not bad. These actually went on a little easier. It's just when you get past the thigh and I'm pulling upwards, it's like, you know, but up to this point, it's not bad. Would I change the sizing? Probably not, to be honest, because a large would be loose. Like, it feels good. It doesn't hurt up here. They're actually not uncomfortable. These are a little bit more comfortable than the grays for some reason. They're not super lightweight, but I would say a medium stretch to them. So not the worst, maybe. Maybe we'd make it to the gym on some day. These black Yes Style leggings feel a little different. I think these are a different product than the others. A little bit of bunching, but nothing too crazy. Probably the same amount as the Gymshark legging. It's not horrible, but a little clumping at the ankle. These are really silky. These are closer to the Airy feel, for sure. Very, yeah, it's not too bad. It's not bad at all. An affordable alternative. All right, so this loungewear set, I'm still wearing the same, like, bralette underneath it so you can see it at the bottom. But this is one of those cinching situations. A little short on me and a little actually kind of bulky in the front area. I couldn't figure out which side was the front and which side was the back. So for all I know, maybe I'm wearing it wrong. But she's workable. You just got a lot of under boob for sure. But I wouldn't want to go into a different sizing because I don't think I would be able to fit the other shirt. These are also a medium. I usually buy mediums in the majority of Yes Style things. I feel like on that site, all the smalls are a little small, if you know what I mean? Like, you need to run one size up with all their brands, typically. But it's okay. She's a little cute. Alrighty, we're in the tie-dye. This is the baby blue. I also bought the green pants. Can you hand me the green pants, Aves? Can I get a little assistance? A little toss, a little oof? Thank you. Oh, the greens have a butterfly on it. Same size, though. Cute, comfy. Lounging, comfy, she's casual, she's hanging. So the random black striped pants. Two stripe, a little tight in the waist, a little bit. I just hope it doesn't shrink, because if it shrinks, it'll suddenly be too uncomfortable to wear. But she's cute. I like how she fits. She's soft. I like soft. We're gonna try on our Bradley Michelle, as they call it. Our little croppy toppy. It's like, she's just at home, you know. But now with the red sweatpants, ooh, the velvet of it all. It's a vibe, y'all. This is so comfy. Oh my god, I'm gonna live in these. They're not too short. They do ride up a little bit when I sit down. If I wore it like below the waist, then it'd be okay, but ooh. Now these sweatpants, these aren't that comfy. They come in white too. Aves, can I have the white, please? Ooh, so we could have a whole situation, like a Backstreet's Back. All right. I kinda like that. It's not uncomfortable, but the waistband could be a little skinnier, but the length is pretty good. Like, my ankles aren't cold. I'd be cool chilling in the yard with these on. This set with the biker shorts comes with a little tank top. I don't have the other garments for it, but it'd be really similar to what I'm wearing right now. So here we are. This shirt I got in black and white. Probably not the best idea to show you guys the black one. It's one of those like cinching shirts. We have the strings, and I feel like the white may show the black bra underneath because it seems pretty sheer. It sits pretty well. It's very comfy, but it is on a thinner side. All right, so that was everything. I didn't try on the bubble gum for you guys. It's actually kind of light pink. All right, so I just finished afternoon yoga, which I do every day with one of the neighbor's kids. We're working on our splits. So we have stretch routines, and it's just our relaxation away from like any stress, whether it be her remote school. She's in middle school this year, so she definitely has a different situation than these folks who are doing virtual school. And then, you know, my little break from work, it's just a good like 40 minutes of like peace. We're looking up at the sky, we're enjoying the weather, we're doing our yoga, we're trying to be flexible. It's not really working. And then we got these little kids who finished school right afterwards. Though they're done with class for the day, we have one homework assignment for her, and this one's gonna do some typing club, which is like a typing program that helps you get better at typing. So it's just more like a elective thing. If not, we're gonna do a little bit of math on a program called Prodigy. So I'm getting set up real quick. As you can see, I chose the tie dye for the day because I'm comfy, and it's Fire Pit Fridays in the neighborhood. So every every Friday, there's a fire pit. We do s'mores sometimes, et cetera, et cetera. And the parents like hang out. The kids go to bed at a certain time and we just chill, sip on something, try to relax with our little compound we got going on. Obviously, we got a lot going on right now. I'm just leaving it there. You don't gotta worry about it now. We're gonna worry about your school stuff. Good morning. It's the weekend. Excuse me. I kind of look cozy, comfy, and a little crappy, but that's just the kind of weekend we're having. So it's Saturday. Kiddos are back. They were gone for just one night, and today we're having a Korean barbecue situation with the neighbors. One of our neighbors first time having Korean barbecue, one of our other neighbors just really misses it. So we're gonna all go to HMR in a little bit, or at least like one person from each household, and get everything we need. I gotta make some of the sauces. I bought little individual sauce cups so I could at least, you know, have enough sauces for each separate table. And then we all have our own little like cooktops that we're gonna use, which is gonna be fun. Ava, Mia, wanna come say hello?
Hello, my name is Mia.
We know. So they're out playing because it's actually a very nice day, don't you think?
Uh-huh.
A little hot, but nice.
Why do you get so close to the camera?
She always does that.
So it's pretty nice. If you're in the sun, it's actually pretty great. They've been running around playing some sort of adventure game.
Yeah.
With their hula hoops. So they're enjoying that. And I am writing a grocery list on the couch with my computer.
I'm a Pisces.
Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness.
I'm all holding right. The mommy.
Chris is sleeping right now because he works on weekends, works night shift. So we're gonna hang out outside since it's a beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day.
Don't know what song we're singing, but okay.
Bubble Guppy song.
Well, now I gotta look up a Bubble Guppy song. In that stage of fall where I change my outfit three times a day. So right now we got some tie-dye green pants, a little butterfly, as you guys, you know about, a tank top because it's kind of hot because the sun's out. It's like 2 p.m, the hottest time of the day. And we just got back from the supermarket, which is really cold. So I had like a hoodie and one of my workout leggings on. So this is gonna be the outfit for the actual eating portion of Korean barbecue because you need your comfy pants on, and I need something that I'm not upset if it gets stained with oil because my Korean barbecue peeps or barbecue peeps, y'all know. So I'm about to start cooking some side dishes. I have some bok choy, so I'm gonna stir fry that, and I also have this bag of shrimp. We won't do a close-up because we want to see uncooked shrimp. And I think I might do like a salt and pepper fried shell on shrimp situation, and then there's gonna be rice, and then we have some like potato salad. All of the meats are in my fridge since we're gonna actually do this on my deck because we need the most flat area where none of our grills are falling over. So I have a portable grill, the little fire parts here with the fuel, and then that will be ours, and everyone else is bringing their own griddle. So it's probably gonna roughly be set up, it's gonna mess up y'all lighting a little, right out here. And then we all have our own little tables and our own little setups per household. We always spread out for the parties, but I'll show you guys the meats because that's the fun part, right? I think. basically my whole fridge is just meat. So we got some pork belly, we got some brisket, more brisket, some marinated bulgogi. I got some kaibi, which wasn't bone-in, and then some spicy pork belly. So I basically cleared out my fridge for this moment because I needed to be able to hold all this stuff. And the sun has decided to come back, so we got some good lighting right now. So when we cook for the parties, we all mask up inside our houses and put on gloves. That's what I'm about to do. I don't want to film it because then something could go horribly wrong and I want the food to go well, but I'll show you guys the food afterwards because we already did a little filming in this vlog. Once I get used to every recipe, like I'm trying new things, then it's easier to film it. But I figured, you know, a little something's better than nothing. Oh, so I got these sauce jars, side note, from Yes Style. So this is an oil one, and then there are ones that say sauce on it, and then there's one that says vinegar on it. And I have a bunch, so my overflow bottles go to the top right now as far as like actual bottles from the store and extra bottles. So I might actually be redoing the spice cabinet again. It's not actually anywhere near a finished product. I need a new spice stand. I have more labels, I haven't used it. But this is what the bottle looks like when you actually put sauces in it. And I think this is genius. I forgot I ordered this, and by the time it came from Yes Style, which was like 3 weeks later, I was like, why didn't I just wait? So I haven't put a real label on it yet, so I have this like label maker label. That's my gochujang sauce. And the cool part is you can pour from the spout, but anything that catches right here in the overflow goes through that little hole right there back into the bottle, so it doesn't get super messy. It's genius. It's amazing. So I'm gonna put these long labels onto it. I don't know if I'm gonna keep some of these. I might. I feel like this is gonna be like an ever-changing thing. I don't have all my containers yet, so it's nowhere near done. So I have vinegar already in here. I also decided to switch my spices to long labels, so I'm gonna redo that because I decided to go with different bottles. Those weren't just doing it for me, like some of the seasonings would get stuck. So work in progress, work in progress. I can hear our mail truck right now passing by. He actually has a very loud truck. I went full Virgo and I bought sauce cups at Target for everyone's dipping sauce at Korean barbecue, because if you're gonna do it, you gotta do it right. I feel like that's a Virgo motto. I should just do it so it's done right. Right? And before y'all at me, I just bottled this and I forgot to put it in the refrigerator. Though the bottle didn't say refrigerator after opening, my Google says it should be. So we're good. We're gooch. Another day, another neighborly hangout. Last night we did Korean barbecue, fire pit, and we also have a projector now. So let me show you guys. Projector itself isn't in the box anymore, but it's actually owned four ways. So we split it with our little neighborhood compound, which is a total of roughly four houses, sometimes five. And yeah, so we have this outside. So we have this one actually, the black one. I originally was like, oh, Chris went with the aesthetic. Okay, no. No, he didn't. But we're gonna use it to watch football, movie nights for the kids once a week, and we just put like a big sheet up against one of the houses and... It actually works really well if it's dark enough, just against the house itself. But depending on where we're sitting next to the fire pit, we have to use like a wall that actually has windows, so we put a sheet up. So the basement is probably the least seen thing because it's not renovated yet. It's painted and it's cute, but it's just not decored out or anything. I haven't fully decided where I want to go with this yet. I'm pretty sure I got a vibe, but it's gonna take time and it's not anywhere near probably gonna be the end of this year. I want a new cover for the bean bag, and then eventually we're gonna switch out our older couch. Like, she's doing fine, so it's no rush,
But I do know like what color couch I'll eventually wanna, you know, get. This is like a Value City couch that we've been like burning into the ground for a little over 5 years right now. Went through, you know, the kids potty training, went through Yuna's puppyhood, and I've been extracting it to try to keep it as clean as I can. The kids have their little kid corner right here, and this is a fireplace that's disconnected. I've mentioned it in the home tour. We'll discuss that in a quick second. I was just doing some laundry because Sunday is for laundry, and your girl is in the comfy pants. Hey! I actually bought some new bedding sheets, so that'll be fun to show you guys. Something I finally invested in because I've been online window shopping with them for months, but they're in the wash right now, so I got some work I need to do.
All right,
we have some info boxes I need to work on. And I need to make a thumbnail, probably have a few emails, and I want to write down some manifestations for the week. So I actually bought a little tiny notebook from Yes Style, and I did this little Pinterest dotted art situation. It has like a little sticker here. Wasn't the greatest, my first time, and I probably just don't have like the thin enough pens to make the details, but that was cute. Eventually I'm gonna work on my handwriting. I'm working on it on separate sheets of papers and like have it say like manifest. Some, you know, on the back I have some post-its. This one just fell out, but what I would like it to look like, these are all from Yes Style, is this post-it right there, and it comes with four of these colors. These are my aesthetic. The fourth one is more of like a teal, so kind of threw everything off, but that's just on the back. So whenever I want to write down things, manifest it, it'll be in that book compared to my planner, which actually started getting really hectic and really messy. I also bought, and that side note since they're right here, like reusable Ziploc pouches from Yes Style, like snack pouches for the kids. I got like two different sizes. I figured why not? They're technically like, you know, not Ziplocs, but why not, you know? We got a pack of the larges, a pack of the mediums. So before I get to work, I want to update you guys on the fireplace behind me. So the kids section isn't like the cleanest thing because they don't have the full space due to the fireplace. There's like a little nook, and that bookshelf is actually locking the crawl space underneath the house, and they store their stuff in the bookshelf too, and they have this in like a bin right there holding like larger Nerf gun situations. So we mentioned, or I mentioned originally, that we're probably gonna not renovate but finish our laundry room, which is on the other side of this wall dead fireplace situation. This is a half bath. The problem is the half bath sticks kind of into the room just due to like sizing, like it has to, and there's no going around that unless you want your sink and your toilet to touch, because it's just a sink and a toilet. But we've been getting quotes, and we are not DIYing it. I will not be DIYing this. Like, I'm cool with a little here and there, but when it comes to electrical and plumbing and then also like finishing drywall, I don't want to do this room specifically. It's an unfinished laundry room. I've shown you guys in my home tour, my empty house tour. You guys can check it out. Because our HVAC is in there, our main electrical panel, all of our water shutoff valves, plus obviously the laundry, like the washer and the dryer. It can go wrong really fast, and there's like a drain in the floor that has to stay exposed because that's like for evaporation from the HVAC. Like, come on. Your girl will cause more damage than good. But I have some design ideas from Pinterest, and since we have to just buy our own supplies for whomever is going to be quoting us for labor, they've been giving me really great feedback, and I've been doing my own research to try to, you know, keep it as affordable, because it's a laundry room. Not everyone's gonna see it. You guys will probably see it the most than anyone else in the world, but being unfinished is not a problem until problems start happening from it being unfinished, and that is starting to happen. So I want to like put floors down and put a ceiling down and be able just to make sure everything's running properly, and maybe like reroute some of the electrical away from the water, which kind of gives me anxiety. But yeah, things to code. I can't wait because I hate doing the laundry because of it. I run through there. It's quite scary at night because you never know. You never know, because of the exposed drain for the HVAC, something can crawl its way up. Not really cool with that. And a floors and ceilings make a big difference. Got a couple quotes. The first quote was ridiculous. Second quote, way better. We're still shopping around. We're still doing our research, but I'm pretty sure we really do like the second quote, but really depends on like down to the contract, the timeline, et cetera, et cetera. So right now we're probably looking at like a little over a week. They quote it underneath it, but you know, you gotta overestimate. So if that happens, you guys will see it. That's a little update. Once that room's finished, then we'll talk about, you know, maybe decoring stuff out and eventually like maybe renovating kitchens and bathrooms. But we're pretty happy with that for now. I would just like the house to be finished. And since we have one unfinished room with a bunch of important things, that's gonna be Chris's gift to me. So that's wonderful. Because girl hates doing laundry right now. Anyway, rambling on. What a great update, right? You guys want home updates? There it is.